Last week, the government tabled 9 tax bills before Parliament for consideration before passing the 2022-2023 financial year budget. Among other things, the government has proposed amendments in the Traffic and Road Safety Act to effectively ban the importation of vehicles that are 9 years old and above.
We are not introducing new taxes. The tax bills we have presented largely focus on streamlining revenue administration in order to get much more revenue.
This amendment, which intends to minimize road accidents associated with importation of old cars and protect the environment from air pollution, has faced resistance from members of parliament who contend that it's going to make vehicles more expensive for Ugandans to afford. Legislators are concerned about the speed at which the government moves to ban old vehicles in disregard of the economic potential of its citizens.
Where we have reached, most of these Ugandans cannot afford those new cars. Although we are failing to get to pay for fuel, we have so many things that we have to cater for that we should allow people to buy cars of reasonable numbers, but not these. Is it 9, 8 years? Which cannot be, it is impossible.
Let it look at the income of our each citizens. Can people afford new cars? And secondly, why do they want to ban these cars? Because even new cars can make accidents.
When they do that, how many people are going to acquire vehicles? Have we empowered our people? Do we have the economy that can allow our people buy new cars? And if taxes have been increased on fuel, why can't they let people buy cars so that they spend the money on buying fuel and then they get indirect tax on fuel rather than saying that they increase taxes on cars?
MPs have vowed to reject the proposal and advised government to step up motor vehicle inspection so as to weed out dangerous mechanical conditioned vehicles from the road.
We should reinstate that and make sure that each vehicle on the road, it is given a time frame, like maybe a year or 2 years, and even after 2 years, we can renew. We take those vehicles back to the Ministry of Works to re-inspect them, whether they are fit to be on the road or not. That would be a solution. But banning them basing on because it is accidents, I don't think that it is really a good idea.
In 2018, the government banned cars older than 15 years from being shipped into the country, following the enactment of the Traffic and Road Safety Amendment Act of 2018. If the proposed amendment succeeds, importation of motor vehicles manufactured before July 2013 will be banned. It will also be extended to cars exempted from environmental levy to 8 years from the original 5 years. MPs have asked government to invest in revenue mobilization strategies to address gaps through which the government is losing revenue, such as understaffing, corruption, lack of technology and capacity, among others.
You know, you sympathize with the taxpayer. Taxpayer has recovered from COVID and you hold him with an iron hand. It is not good. There could be some amnesties. So when you grant amnesty, and forgive, for example, interest and penalties, you can attract people to pay the major tax.
For instance, local government, how do they streamline with Uganda Revenue Authority that we want them to have the tax they collect for them to have a fair share? But the method of correction, because what happens, you find that actually a lot of money, business people or Ugandans pay it to dodge tax than pay tax.
I would pray to the government to make this country zero tolerance to corruption, because I believe there are a lot of taxes that are being harvested from various sectors, but sometimes how the end of that money, it's the question now.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.